Hi guys, I'm on my mum's camera at the moment, so I don't know what the recording quality's like is. But it's pretty windy, so I'm just gonna put some tape over the mic so I don't pick it up so much. So, one sec. And then I'll tell you what we're doing. Good old teeth. So, hopefully you can still hear me. Right, basically today, I'm getting some wood cut that should be ready within the next day or two. And I'm going to see if I can take the 6-inch out of this now. So that means destructing like the box, basically. But I'm going to try to do it so I don't smash it up too much. Alright guys, be right back with you. Alright, back at you. Luckily, it's coming undone quite easily, and I don't think we'll have too many problems with this, hopefully. Yeah, just check if we're still recording. And out of all the things to find inside a speaker, I found a beer top. Man, I'll show you a little trick. I don't know if you can do that. Oh yeah. Oh yeah, between the thumb and finger. Leave a video response if you can do that, or you doing that yourself. This is the inside of the box. We've got the subwoofer there. Nice and stiff. This is the mid-range. And the highs. And this is the port here. Now that's quite a hefty port, so I could use that for another project, but I didn't want to attack these too much because I might seal them back up at a later date. But as you can see, it's a bit rough along there, but it's not too bad, not too bad. Right, so we're going to see if we can get this sub out. Oh, that's close. That's very close. Now these subs look very much like the ones that Sam at Bearvids had. The ones where he bent the bus around the outside. I don't know if you watched any of his videos, but they're quite like the ones that he had, so to be honest, they probably are the same ones. And aiwa will probably use a lot of the same subs within their boxes anyway. But I am, like I said, I'm getting that the woodcut at the moment for the twin six, and so that should sound pretty nice. No, I don't. Here we go. Here we go. At least the connections and it's soldered as well. There we have it, ladies and gentlemen. Let me just check if it is 6 inches. So excited. I don't know, this ain't got inches on it. A bit thick when it comes to stuff like that. We will check later. I'm so happy with that. Man, look. Comes out and it looks brand new. But it's quite stiff. Suspension's nice and soft. Yeah, all in all, that's awesome. Very happy with that. So, what I am going to do is, I don't know whether to film me taking the other one out of the box, I'm not sure yet, but I'm going to take that one into my room and we'll test it, so be right back. Hi guys, sorry about the dirt on my face, I haven't been in the shower from work yet. See, I got in and then the first thing I've done was kind of take the 6 inches out of the box, and yes, they are 6 inches. I just measured them just for reassurance. They sound pretty nice. I just turned it up like a second before and I put this on. This is when kind of look, I've got a little kind of graphic equalizer thing on here. Look, I've got bass, I've got it on 14, and I've got my trebles on minus 14. So I thought I'd just do that. So it kind of eliminates some of the mid-range and treble out of it. I can't seem to find my stereo remote from the BD app at the moment, but no doubt that will turn up. And then I've got like a super bass button on that, so I'll probably just use that for the twin sixes. But I'm really looking forward to getting that anyway, so getting all that box ready. A little speaker doesn't have to perform well, but anyway, I'm running out of time on this camera card, so that's just a quick little demo before I run out of time. Anyway, so I've got 10 seconds left, so see you later, guys. As Jerry would say, peace, guys.